Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the music theory series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Today we're going to focus on trap melodies and how to start your melody. Now it may come out trap, it may not, but we're going to aim for trap for a specific reason. I'll tell you why later. But let's get started on how to start a melody. If you have no idea, you're not going to need any other plugins that don't come with FL Studio. So let's go inside your channel rack, which is right here. Click the plus icon and let's go to Fruity DX10. It has some pretty decent presets in here. All right, now that you have Fruity DX10 open, I'm using my MIDI controller to trigger notes. It comes with a decent sound. Now with modern music, it's not really, it is about the sound source, but it's also not about the sound source, especially trap. Trap is more so sound source plus what you do to the sound. That makes it trap. Okay, so let's say you have no idea where to start with melody. Let's right click, let's go to piano roll. Let's go to piano roll options, let's go to helpers, let's go to scale highlighting, and let's pick out a scale. Now again, knowing music theory will help you a lot better with this because you're not just picking random stuff. You'll understand why you're doing stuff. You'll have a lot more fluid motion throughout these. But let's say you wanted to create a trap track. Let's just go to the Arabic scale. The reason I picked this scale is because it has a lot of different interval jumps, so people get out of their bubble of major and minor scales. Next up, we're gonna go to piano roll options, go to helpers, scale highlighting, and let's switch out the root note for, let's say, B flat, which would be A sharp. Okay, so now it highlights our root note right here. Okay, now again, you don't have to know theory to apply these techniques. That's the whole point. So the first thing is we're going to start on the root note, which is that highlighted note. In this case, it's A sharp. Okay, now I like my snap to grid on a half beat usually. And what else do I do? I like to zoom in until I can see the bar and at about a quarter of the screen, and I have my piano roll at full width. So those are the things that let me create better. So this is the proper zoom. And to zoom in and out, you use your mouse wheel on this little darker icon here, black strip. Okay, now we're going to use the metronome and let's start at 140 BPM. Now all you have to do here is just go up or down your scale. That's the easiest way to start, is simply go note by note up or down your scale. You can skip notes if you want, but going up or down the scale will make it super easy to get started. Let's turn this down a little bit, it's a little loud. Okay, and that's how you understand what makes the scale identity. This, you've heard this up and down motion so much with the Arabic scale that you associate it with anything that has to do with the desert or Aladdin or any kind of Eastern music or, you know, that style of music. Okay, so ingrained in our society and culture. That's what we associate it with. So that's why I said going up and down the scale will identify the scale identity based on the intervals in between. Now instead of doing the over and over and over again, let's create a second portion to the melody. I'm gonna go. Okay, so I don't know where I want to go from here, but let's start at F sharp, and let's go down the scale. Okay, let's do one more thing to kind of trapify it, so to speak. Let's go to our channel rack. Let's send this to mixer channel one. If you don't see that, hit Alt plus M to hide or reveal those numbers. If you don't see it, go to your sound, click on the wrench tool, and then go to your track number, switch that to one. So go to your mixer now, which is this icon. We're gonna load up a plugin called Grossbeat, which comes with FL Studio. I forget which edition. I bought Grossbeat, so it was one of the things. I have producer edition, but I bought Grossbeat. But you can still use the demo version if you wanna apply this technique. So go to Grossbeat, go to Presets, we're gonna go to Momentary, and go to, where is this, Half Speed, okay? Now in the mixer, I'm gonna lower the mix level so it doesn't use only half speed, because if I leave this all the way up, it will play only half speed. But let's blend it, let's pull this back a bit. Now we have that trap bounce. Okay, so over time, you're gonna learn the nuances of melody, but in this case, it's repeating itself even though I've created an ending. So what I'm gonna do is have it repeat three times and then have the ending so that they're two separate events. And you can blend in the half speed effect. Now I'm gonna fix the sound a little bit. If you want to get really exotic, you can add extensions to your melody. Now I hear in my head this. Now this is going outside your scale. This is a little more complex. This is what we teach at busyworksbeats.com/music theory. But you can see this note sounds good even though it's outside of the scale. So the traditional way you're taught, which is learning scales first, can almost lock you in a box if that's all you think is the reality, staying inside of a scale. There's more to music theory than staying inside of a scale, and that's what we teach at busyworksbeats.com/music theory. This would be a harmonization here. Now I'm gonna kind of spice it up so we have that modern trap vibe by adding harmonies here. So notes that go along with the melody. Let's pull this up an octave. I need to turn off the half speed effect. That half time. You can pull it up an octave if you think the halftime is too low of an octave. Okay. So that is the technique. Again, you can learn more at busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Thanks for watching today. I'll leave a link below. It's busyworksbeats.com.